Hello, boys and girls. Welcome back to another lesson in Algebra 1. This is Mr. Bean. I'm going to be working through Unit 11 with you as we're going to learn about how to solve quadratics. But our first lesson is going to be some review, actually, for middle school, because it's going to be so rad. When I was in middle school, there was a great movie that came out called Rad. I loved it. So I figured, hey, this is perfect because today we are studying radicals. This movie actually is awful. I just saw a trailer of it and I was like, oh my gosh, I liked this movie. When I was 12 years old, it was really cool. So today, talking about radicals, but before that, we've got to focus in on perfect squares. You've got to know these things really, really well. So what in the world is a perfect square? Perfect squares are when we take a number and we multiply itself by itself. In other words, you square it. So 1 squared is 1. 2 squared is 4. That means the square root of 4 is also 2. So what are the rest of these? 3 squared, 4 squared, 5 squared. Okay, so you can fill out all of these. Those are perfect squares. Continue down the line here, 16, 25, 36, and so forth. You have to memorize these. You must know them. Okay, so as you're writing them down, don't just write them down. To write them down, you gotta think, okay, I gotta have these memorized. It's just the squares of 1 through 12. We could keep going more than that, but we don't really need to. Really, 1 through 10 is the most important, but you'll have some here in this lesson with 11 and 12 that'll show up in your packet. Okay, so get those down. Pause if you need to, but again, you've got to have them memorized, which you'll get much better at as we go on. So with number 1, what you're going to do here is approximate a square root to 1 decimal, and you are not using a calculator. All right, it's important that in this lesson, you don't go jump and grab a calculator because that's not how you're going to do this. Unless, of course, you're in Mr. Kelly's class, because Mr. Kelly seems to let you use a calculator for everything. Say, when you go to take the master's check, Mr. Bean said, Mr. Kelly, I'm not supposed to use a calculator. All right, thank you, if you are in his class. All right, so square root of 10. What we're going to do is this. I want you to write down the square root of 10, and we're going to say that it's in between two different numbers. What are these in between? We're going to look right here. Square root of 10 is right about here, right? In between the square root of 9 and square root of 16. So that's what we say. We say it's in between the square root of 9 and the square root of 16. That will help us because now we can simplify this. Less than square root of 10, less than 4. Square root of 9 is 3, square root of 16 is 4. See, they're equivalent, square roots. So now we know that the square root of 10 must be 3 point something because it's in between 3 and 4. So you estimate, I'd say 10 is really close to 9, so I'm just going with 3.1. That would be about my estimate, 3.1. Okay, that's how you show your work on doing these problems, without a calculator, just trying to estimate. Okay, so here, let's do square root of 90. So square root of 90 is in between what two perfect squares? It's going to be in between square root, so this is how you set it up. 90 is right around here somewhere, so it's in between 81 and 100, so we put 81 here, and 100 here. And so then the square root of 90 is in between the number 10 on the upper side and 9 on the lower side. So that means it is 9 point something. 9 point what? Well, 90, if you look here at 81 and 100, 90 is right about the middle in between. It's not perfectly in the middle, but it's really close. So we could say 9.5. And that would be our answer. This would be your work. That's how you justify with inequalities. And that's what we're going to be looking for. All right. Why don't you actually pause right here. Pause for this one. Try this one on your own, and I'll have the answer appear in just a second. What you see in red here underneath each number is I grabbed a calculator and just checked real quick. What's the square root of 10 with more accurate values with a calculator? So look, our answers were pretty darn close. That's what you're trying to do, is just be about close where you think it is. As long as you're within a couple decimals, you'll be fine. Moving on here, we're gonna do some more middle school stuff that you've done in the past, but it may have been a little confusing. So what I'm hoping today is for those kids who struggle with this, we're gonna try and get this clarified. So I'm making you do two methods. I know it's a pain. I'm gonna make you do it two different ways, but the reason why these two different ways are going to help you, because a lot of times you want to do a mixture of these two methods. And if you know them both really well, then these are easy problems. If you only know one particular method, then this can be a pain in the butt to be able to work through these. All right, so divide by a perfect square. What that means is we want to take radical 50, and we're going to break radical 50 up into two numbers. And those two numbers, one of them is going to be a perfect square. So here's 50. 50 would be about here, just, oh, right over here. So what can perfect square, look at these numbers here, perfect squares can go into 50, divide into it evenly. So let's start with the largest perfect square, that's important. Can 49 go into 50? No. Can 36 divide into it? No. Can 25 go into it? Yes. 25 divides perfectly into 50. And how many times? Twice. So 25 times 2 is 50. Well, that makes this really easy. Now, we can separate the radical, and it is radical 25 times radical 2, and then the square root of 25 is 5. And then you still have square root of 2, and that is the answer. Not too bad. So if you can recognize the perfect square, this way is really fast. When you don't recognize the perfect square, it takes a little bit more work. So let's take 50, and what can go into 50? What evenly goes into it? Well, I know a 2 can go into 50. Actually, let's not do 2, because that will give us the same number. Let's say 5. 5 goes into 50. So 5, and then 50, what's left after I divide it by 5? A 10 is left. Okay, now let's do this. Next line down, and I'm going to take the number 10 and break that one up into two different numbers. So I take my 5, and then 10 can divide up into another 5 times 2. And now I have prime factors. The reason these are prime is because we cannot divide them up anymore. There's no other numbers that divide into them. So here's what we do. After you have your prime factors, you look for pairs. If I can find little buddies that are with each other like that in a group of 2, then what happens is those will cancel and it comes outside the radical as a 5. And what's left on the inside is radical 2. And you get exactly the same answer. Let me say that again. You're looking for groups of 2. They cancel each other and come out of the radical as one radical here. Okay. Some of you might be thinking, man, Mr. Bean, the first way was a lot easier. Yeah, that's true. With some of these, this will be easier, but you're going to see there's reasons behind my madness here. Prime factors are going to help us later on in this lesson. So number 5, let's try the prime factors first this time. So what are the prime factors? Let's see. This 3 in front, we just got to write 3 radical. Okay, let's take 48 and divide that up. So that's just going to become 2 times 24. Because I know a 2 goes into it evenly. There's probably other things. There's lots of things. But I'm just going to try something that I know for sure. And then let's take 2 times. Now let's take 24 and break it up. So 24 is going to be 2 times 12. All right. So now what do we have next? We're going to have 2 times 2 times. And now I take the 12 and I'm going to break that up. 2 times 6. Oh my goodness, we're still going. So this is now 2, that 2 comes down, times 2, times that 2 comes down, 2, and the 6 has to break up now into a 2 times 3. Okay, we've got our prime factors. So we do a pair of buddies right here. There's a pair of buddies, 2 twos, and there's a pair of buddies right there. And let's write this out. So we've got 3 times. Now, that pair comes out as 1 2 on the outside of the radical, times that pair comes out as another 2 on the outside. Radical 3 is left on the inside. That's the only thing left. And our answer is 3 times 2 is 6, times 2 is 12, radical 3. All right, let's see if the perfect square method was easier. So the first thing is I have this 3, and then I'm going to have 48, and I'm going to say a perfect square times something equals 48. So let's take 48 right here. Can 36 go into 48? No. Can 25 go into 48? No. Can 16 go into 48? 16, 32. Yeah, it does. 48. So 16 times, it goes in 3 times. So 16 times 3 will give us 48. So now we just go down one more level. This is going to become, I'm going to show that I break this apart. 16 times radical 3, because the square root can just divide up like that. It can be separated into two different numbers. I get 3 times 4, radical 3 stays underneath, and then 3 times 4 is 12. Wow, that was fast. Okay, so you can see there's going to be sometimes that is a much, much faster way of doing it than trying to do this. It's just whatever way you're more comfortable with. All right, number 6 here. I put this one on here to show you something that sometimes with the perfect squares, it's kind of hard to figure out exactly what perfect squares. So I don't know what the largest one is, but I know off the top of my head that 4 can go into 80 evenly. And 4 is a perfect square, so let's just do that. 4 times 20 is going to give me 80. All right, so now can I break it down any more into other perfect squares? Yes, I can, because 20 breaks down into 4 times 5. So you can see this is kind of a mixture of what I was doing before with the prime factors, because the square root of 4 times the square root of 4, well, that's, I could either just cancel those out if I want, or I could put them back together and say that that's 16 times radical 5. There's so many different ways of doing this. And then square root of 16 is 4, so I get a 4. See, I totally could have skipped this step if I just recognized there's two of them, go straight to the 4 on the outside. And then the 5 is still under the radical with an answer of 20 radical 5. I know I'm doing this fast, but this is supposed to be some review. I'm just trying to help those of you who've struggled with this and never really learned it. Okay, next one. Let's do 80. I'm going to speed this up because this does take me a little while. Just kind of follow along with me.
5 on the outside, 80 becomes 2 times 40. Ah! And then it's going to become 5 times 2 times 2 times 20. I'm going to have to break up the 20. 5 times 2 times 2 times. That's going to be 2 times 10. Break up the 10. 5 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 5. And then I'm looking for pairs. I'm going to have a pair there, and I'm going to have a pair there. So I have 5 times 2. That's going to be gone now. Those 2's come out as one single 2 on the outside, and I'm left with a radical 5.
All right, 5 times 2 is 10, times 2 is 20. Same answer, 20 radical 5. Okay, number 7. I want you to do both methods. Pause the video now, and after you are done, go ahead and resume the video, and we'll see how you did. And there's your answer. 10 radical 3 should have been the answer. You can see both ways that I did this. And then there's the trick here was sometimes you might not write the two numbers that are buddies, the pairs, next to each other. That's okay. If you see that there's two of them, just kind of circle them, and those are the ones you're going to cancel as it becomes one on the outside of the radical. For the next problem set, we're going to multiply and simplify these things. So this is where the method of prime factors are really helpful. Okay, watch what I'm about to do. Do not write this down. If I did 10 times 35, I'd get 350. So I'd have to do the square root. What the heck's wrong with that red? There we go. Square root of 350. So 350, oh my goodness, I got to break this down into perfect squares, and that could be a pain. You might know it, you might not. It's a little bit of a pain. But watch how much easier it is if I just think what breaking this down into prime factors already. So with this one, I could just say this is all going to be one radical, and I've got 10 breaks up into 2 times 5. And 35 can break up into 5 times 7. So there might not be any perfect squares among inside each individually, but together, you've got a buddy of 5s. And so those 5s can come outside of the radical, put a 5 outside here, and then I am left with radical. 2 and 7 do not simplify anymore, so they can just go right back together. 5 radical 14. Isn't that radical? Yeah! Okay, number 9. So now we're going to go 4 times the number in front here is an imaginary 1. You don't see it, but it's a little imaginary 1 right there. So that's what we pretend are. So we have a 4. Radical. 6 and 24. Let's break 6 up. So 6 is 2 times 3. 24 is going to be 2 times 12. Okay, so let's keep breaking this down. In fact, I'm going to show you something as I'm going, because there's so many different ways of doing this. I'm going to rearrange this 2 and this 2 to be together. So I've got 2 times 2 together, then the times 3. So all I did is I just took these three numbers, rearranged them. It's multiplication. I can do that. Okay, now let's take this 12, and there's a perfect square in the 12, right? Because it's 4 times 3. That will make this a little easier. So you can mix and match your different strategies as you're working. So there's a pair of buddies. The 4 is a perfect square, so it can cancel. Oh, look. And then there is a pair of buddies. This is a weird little circle here that I'm drawing. There's a pair. Those two 3s. It would have been easier if I wrote them next to each other. Okay, so I have the 4 that's already on the outside times. That group of 2s comes out as a single 2. That group of 3s comes out as a single 3. And there's my weird red line. And then the square root of 4 is just a 2. So notice that there's no radical left anymore. There's nothing underneath that square root symbol. So now we just go 4 times 2 is 8. 8 times 3 is a big number, 16, 24. And then 24 times 2 is 48 There is our answer. All right, number 10 you're going to try on your own. So you'll pause here in just a second, but let me get you started. When you're multiplying things, these coefficients, we call them just like coefficients, like if they're in front of a variable, they just multiply. So we're going to go 5 times 2 is 10, radical, and then you finish this off. All right, so pause now and you finish. We'll see if you get the same answer as me. Boom, there's your answer. 2, 10, radical 2. So if you see here, I just broke up 14 as 2 times 7. I saw the buddies of 7, brought that out. And then I saw 9 was already a perfect square, so no reason to break it up. And I brought that down as a 3. Okay. So again, when you're working through your practice, you can mix and match any of your strategies you want. Just make sure you're showing your work. Do not go straight to answers. That doesn't work. You got to show your steps how you're doing this. That way, when you're making mistakes, we can help you figure out what you're doing wrong. All right, the last problem set. Before we do these problems, let's do a review. Can you please write this over on the left side of your notes off your screen, way over here on the left side? Okay, so do that, what I'm writing here. Don't write this problem here, that would make no sense. Whoops, I don't want a Y, I want an X. There we go. So write 3X plus 2X. What does that equal? It equals 5X. You just add things together, really simple. What's this called? Like terms. If you have an x and an x, you can multiply or add them together, or you could subtract them. But if I had a 3x plus 2y, it's done. You cannot add those together because they're not like terms. Okay, so not possible, it's finished. It is simplified. So that's actually exactly what we're going to do with this part of the lesson. So in fact, stay on the side over there on your notes. So if I had 3 square root of 2 plus 2 square root of 2, you can put those together and get 5 square root of, what in the world? That is weird. Sorry, I don't know what the heck's going on. 5 square root of 2. It's from my radical, that movie. It didn't like it. All right, but if I have 3 radical 2 and I'm going to add 2 radical 7, something like that, oh, not possible. Not like terms. And so you cannot put these together because the radicals are not exactly the same. Okay, that is the same rule with this as if they were just variables. So knowing that, now let's go ahead and try to simplify these things here with addition and subtraction. You know what? I should have made one of these addition. Okay, so I'll fix this. Your notes should already be fixed. I'm gonna make that one a plus. Yeah, okay. So with the first one, you can't subtract these because the radicals are not the same, right? So let's simplify first. Maybe then the radicals would be the same, which they will, because that would be dumb if I didn't do that. So let's simplify this one to 2 radical 9 times 3 minus radical 3. And then we get, this is 2 times, radical 9 is just a 3. And I still have the radical 3 in there, minus radical 3. And so, okay, so we now have 6 radical 3 minus radical 3. So 6 radical 3s minus 1 radical 3. Remember, there's like an imaginary 1 in front of there. The answer is 5 square root of 3. Boom. All right, 12. Again, this is addition. So let's break this down. 45 is going to be the same thing as 9 times 5. Plus 2 radical. Now 20 I can make as a 4 times 5. All right, so then I have 4 radical 9. I'm going to circle these things that are going to simplify. Radical 9 comes out and radical 4 comes out because those are perfect squares. Sweet. So square root of 9 is 3. Radical 5 plus 2 times square root of 4 is 2. And then I have radical 5, so I'm almost done here. 12 radical 5 plus 4 radical 5. Now, since they are the same square roots, the same radicals, it's like terms, and I can add these things together and get 16 radical 5. All right. Okay, last problem. Why don't you pause right now, try this one on your own, and I'll have the answer pop up here right after you're done. All right, my final answer, there it is, negative 17 square root of 2. I had to take a perfect square of 25 out of that puppy right there, and then it simplified. 3 times 5 is 15. Okay, you made it through this. That was our first lesson to set us up to be successful for the rest of this unit on radicals. This is going to be a radical mastery check with a radical packet. All right, Rocket, we will see you back in the next lesson.